Hello students, welcome back to the online geometry session. As you all know, we are doing the second lesson, Pythagoras theorem. In the previous session, we have learned the application of Pythagoras theorem. In that, we have seen the relation between the side opposite to acute angle and the remaining two angles of a triangle. Also, we have seen the relation between the side opposite to obtuse angle and the remaining two angles of a triangle. Now let's take a quick revision of it. Here I have considered one triangle ABC. In that, angle C is an acute angle and segment AD is perpendicular to segment BC. Then we have the relation between the side opposite to acute angle and the remaining two angles of the triangle. What was the statement? Yes, AB square is equal to BC square plus AC square minus 2BC into DC. Now how to remember this statement? Just remember like this. If you have considered angle C as an acute angle, then the side opposite to acute angle square is equal to the remaining two, sum of the remaining two sides square, that is BC square plus AC square minus 2 into base, that is BC, and the into CD. So that way you have to remember this statement. Now let's see the relation between the side opposite to obtuse angle and the remaining two angles of a triangle. Now here I have considered triangle ABC. In that, angle ACB is an obtuse angle. Then we have segment AD is perpendicular to segment BC. So the statement will become as AB square is equal to BC square plus AC square plus 2BC into DC. The same way we have done for the acute angle, same way we have to remember the side opposite to obtuse angle square is equal to the sum of square of the remaining two sides, that is BC square plus AC square plus 2 into base, that is BC into DC. So that way you have to remember. Now if you observe these two statements, both the statements are exactly similar, only the difference is between the this plus sign. In acute angle, here we are writing minus sign, and for acute angle we are writing plus sign. The rest all statement is same. Now let's start with the next theorem, that is Apollonius theorem. Now this theorem is very important. You have to understand this, and the previous application, whatever we have seen, that was for the Apollonius theorem only. So here what is the statement for this? In triangle ABC, if M is the midpoint of side BC, then AB square plus AC square is equal to 2AM square plus 2BM square. So this is the statement for the Apollonius theorem. And we have to prove that AB square plus AC square is equal to 2AM square plus 2BM square. Now in previous two examples, or in previous application of Pythagoras theorems, we have taken acute angle and obtuse angle differently. And in this example or in this theorem, we are taking it together. In one triangle only, we are considering acute angle and obtuse angle. Now let's see how. Here I have considered triangle ABC. In triangle ABC, M is given as midpoint. So if M is a midpoint, then AM will become the median of triangle ABC. So AM is the median, and you have to prove the statement. Now let's start with the theorem. In the beginning of any theorem, what we will write? Yes, given. So let's write given part. In triangle ABC, M is the midpoint of side BC. To prove that AB square plus AC square is equal to 2AM square plus 2BM square. As we writing here, M is the midpoint of side BC, we can say here BM is equal to MC. Now here we have to do one construction. Draw segment AD perpendicular to BC. So we have drawn here segment AD, which is perpendicular to segment BC. Now let's start with the proof. If segment AM is not perpendicular to segment BC, now what is given to us? That M is the midpoint of segment BC. So if it is a midpoint, it is not necessarily that it is perpendicular. So we can write here segment AM is not perpendicular to segment BC. So we have drawn here perpendicular segment as segment AD. So if segment AM is not perpendicular, then out of angle AMB and angle AMC, one will be acute angle and one will be obtuse angle. Because it is not perpendicular, so it will not be a 90 degree angle. So one will be acute angle and the other will be obtuse angle. So in the given figure, angle AMB is an obtuse angle and angle AMC is acute angle. So we will apply the Pythagoras theorem here, application of Pythagoras theorem. From example 1 and 2, whatever we have seen in the last session, that examples we have to consider. AB square is equal to AM square plus BM square plus 2BM into MD. If you are considering triangle AMB, here angle M is an obtuse angle. So whatever statement for obtuse angle we have taken, that you have to write here. So side opposite to obtuse angle square, that is AB square, is equal to the sum of square of remaining two sides, that is AM square plus MB square plus 2BM, that is base, into the perpendicular whatever we have drawn. So into MD, that will be your statement 1 or the equation 1. Now let's write equation 2, that is if M is an acute angle, then the side opposite to acute angle, that is AC square, is equal to the sum of square of remaining two sides, that is AM square plus MC square minus 2 into base, that is MC into MD. So that will be for acute angle. Now AC square is equal to AM square plus MB square minus 2BM into MD. So this statement we can change because BM is equal to MC. Because M is given as midpoint of segment BC, so BM and MC will become equal. So instead of MC, we can write here BM. So write this equation as equation 2. So from equation 1 and 2, if you add equation 1 and 2, you will get AB square plus AC square is equal to, now if you add these two statements, see here, AM square plus AM square will become 2AM square plus MB square plus MB square will become 2MB square plus and minus, and both these terms are equal. So plus and minus, we can cancel these terms. So your last statement will be AB square plus AC square is equal to 2AM square plus 2BM square. So hence we have proved the Apollonius theorem. Now there are different cases also. Now here AM is given as median. It is not mentioned there. It should have mentioned, but it is not there. But they have given you M as a midpoint. So AM will become median of a triangle. So now if you consider AM as a perpendicular segment to BC. So let's consider segment AM perpendicular to BC. Then we will see what is the Apollonius theorem. In triangle AMB. Now here two triangles are forming. So first we will consider triangle AMB. Angle AMB is equal to 90 degree. So by Pythagoras theorem, AB square is equal to BM square plus AM square. Write this equation as equation 3. Here we are applying simple Pythagoras theorem for right angle triangle. So hypotenuse square is equal to sum of the square of other two sides. That way here we have written here. Now we will consider triangle AMC. In triangle AMC, angle M is a 90 degree. So again we will apply the Pythagoras theorem here. So AC square is equal to MC square plus AM square. Write this equation as equation 4. But BC, MC is equal to BM, as M is the midpoint of side BC. Write this equation as equation 5. And every time you have to write the reason also. So it will become AC square is equal to MC square plus AM square. This will be your equation 6. And you have taken this equation from 4 and 5. Now if you add equation 3 and equation 6, you will get AB square plus AC square is equal to AM square plus BM square plus AM square plus BM square. Now AM square plus AM square will become 2AM square, and BM square plus BM square will become 2BM square. Hence we have proved the Apollonius theorem. So anyway we can prove the Apollonius theorem. If AM is the median, then we have to do one construction. We have to first draw a perpendicular segment, and then we can prove the Apollonius theorem. And if directly if AM is given as median, then directly by applying the Pythagoras theorem we can prove the Apollonius theorem. I hope you have understood this theorem. This is known as the Apollonius theorem. Now let's try to solve some problems based on Apollonius theorem from practice set 2.2. In triangle PQR, point S is the midpoint of side QR, and if PQ is equal to 11, PR is equal to 17, and PS is equal to 13, find QR. So let's see the figure for this. Here PQ is given as 11, QR you have to find out, PR is given as 17, PS is given as 13. So that way you have to draw the figure. Now let's start with the solution. In triangle PQR, first we will write what is given to you. Point S is the midpoint of side QR. It is given to you. So segment PS will be the median of a triangle. Therefore, if median is given and triangle is given, you can apply the Pythagoras theorem, Apollonius theorem. So by the Apollonius theorem, what is the statement? PQ square plus PR square is equal to 2 into PS square plus 2 into QS square. Because here PSR is the angle, PSR is an obtuse angle, and angle PSQ is an acute angle. So accordingly we have written the Apollonius theorem. Now substitute the values. PQ is given as 11, PR is given as 17, 2 into PS is given as 13, and QS we have to find out. So 2 into QS square. Now let's find out the square of these values. So 11 square is 121, 17 square is 289 is equal to 2 into 13 square is 169 plus 2 into QS square. Now add these two values, you will get 410 is equal to 2 into 169 is 338 plus 2 into QS square. Therefore 2SR square is equal to 410 minus 338. So you will get here SR square is equal to 36. If you find out, or if you take a square root on the both side, you will get SR is equal to 36 square is 6 units. Write the reason as taking square root on both sides. Now QR is equal to 2 into QS, because S is the midpoint of segment QR. So reason you will write here, S is the midpoint of QR. Therefore QR is equal to 2 into QS is 6, because QS and SR have equal measures. So QS is equal to SR. If you have SR as 6, your QS will be also 6. So you will write here 2 into 6 is equal to 12 units. So this is your final answer. Now let's see the second example or second question. In triangle ABC, AB is equal to 10, AC is equal to 7, BC is equal to 9. Then find the length of the median drawn from point C to side AB. Now here you have to draw a median from point C on to side AB, that you have to find. Now start with the solution. Let CD be the median drawn from vertex C to side AB. BD is equal to half the AB. Now BD, as CD is the median, that means D will be the midpoint of side AB. So BD will become half the length of AB. So reason you will write as D is the midpoint of AB. Now let's substitute the value. AB is given as 10. So half into 10 is equal to 5 units. In triangle ABC, segment CD is the median. It is given to you. So if in triangle median is given, you can apply the Apollonius theorem. So AC square plus, now here D, angle D, angle ADC, this angle is an acute angle, and angle CDB is an obtuse angle. So whenever you are having acute and obtuse angle formed by the median, you can apply the Apollonius theorem. So here what you will write, the side opposite to acute angle, that is AC square plus BC square, is equal to 2 into median square, that is CD square, plus 2 into BD square. So that is Apollonius theorem. Now let's substitute the values. AC is given as 7, BC is given as 9, CD we have to find out, that means median length, into 2 into 5 square. 7 square is 49, 9 square is 81, 2 into CD square plus 2 into 5 square is 25. After calculating all these values, you will get here 130 is equal to 2 into CD square plus 50. So 2 CD square is equal to 130 minus 50, that is equal to 80. When you shift this 2 to the right hand side, you will get CD square is equal to 80 upon 2, that is equal to 40. Therefore CD is equal to square root of 40. Reason you will write, taking square root of both sides. So root 40 you can write as 4 into 10. So 4 square root is 2 and root 10 will remain as it is. So your answer is 2 root 10 units. So therefore the length of the median drawn from point C to A side AB is 2 root 10 units. That will be your final answer. This is the last sum of practice set 2.2. You will find it little lengthier one. You will think that it is very difficult. But if you go stepwise, you will understand it properly and you will be able to write it. It is a very simple sum. Now let's see. In figure, point T is in the interior of rectangle PQRS. Prove that TS square plus TQ square is equal to TP square plus TR square. Now here one hint is given how you will prove it. They have asked you to draw segment AB parallel to side SR and ATB should be collinear. Now here we will draw the construction. Through point T we will draw a parallel segment AB parallel to side SR such that ATB are collinear, PAS are collinear and QB are also collinear. Now let's start with the proof. Segment PS, now this segment PS is parallel to segment QR, opposite sides of the rectangle. We know that opposite side of the rectangle are parallel. Then therefore AS is parallel to SR. If PS is parallel to QR, then AS will be also parallel to BR, because PAS are collinear and QBR points are also collinear. Also, we can write AB is parallel to SR. This is our construction. Therefore, quadrilateral ASRB, this quadrilateral we can write as a parallelogram by definition. If the opposite sides are parallel, then that quadrilateral we call it as parallelogram. But angle S is equal to 90 degree, angles of a rectangle PSRQ. Now here, this is a rectangle PSRQ. So this angle will be 90 degree. So from this quadrilateral parallelogram also, this angle is of 90 degree. Therefore, we can write quadrilateral ASRB is a rectangle. What reason you will write here? A parallelogram is a rectangle if one of its angle is a right angle. Therefore, angle SAB is equal to angle ABR. These two angles will be also of 90 degree. Reason you will write as angles of a rectangle, and this angle is also of 90 degree because this is the angle of rectangle. Therefore, segment TA, this segment is perpendicular to side PS, and segment TB is perpendicular to side QR. Write this equation as equation 1. Therefore, if it is a perpendicular, AS is equal to BR. What reason you will write here? Opposite sides of the rectangle are equal. Similarly, we can prove that AP is equal to BQ. Similarly, we can prove that AP will be equal to BQ because they are also opposite sides of the rectangle. Write this equation as equation 3. Now we have to consider one triangle TAS. Now in triangle TAS, angle A is a 90 degree. So angle TAS is equal to 90 degree from 1, because we have shown that this is a perpendicular drawn on PS. Therefore, by Pythagoras theorem, TS square, that is opposite, here we are having T. So TS square is equal to TS square plus AS square. Write this equation as equation 4. Now we have to consider triangle TATBQ. This triangle we have to, this triangle we have to consider. Here also angle B is an 90 degree. So we will apply the Pythagoras theorem here. So TQ square is equal to TB square plus BQ square. Write this equation as equation 5. If you add equation 4 and 5, you will get TS square plus TQ square is equal to TS square plus AS square plus TB square plus BQ square. Write this equation as equation 6. Now we have to consider other triangle TAP. This triangle you will consider. Again, angle A will be of 90 degree. So you will get here TP square is equal to TA square plus AP square. What reason you will write as? By Pythagoras theorem. Write this equation as equation 7. Now again, what triangle we can consider here? Triangle TBR. In this triangle also, angle B is of 90 degree. So you will get TR square is equal to TB square plus BR square. Write this equation as equation 8. And reason you will write as by Pythagoras theorem. Now again, you have to add equation 7 and 8. So we will get here TP square plus TR square is equal to TA square plus AP square plus TB square plus BR square. Now here, therefore, TP square plus TR square is equal to TA square. Now AP is equal to BQ. We have shown this AP is equal to BQ in equation 2. Similarly, we can write BR is equal to AS. So instead of BR, we can write AS from equation 3. So our equation becomes TP square plus TR square is equal to TA square plus BQ square plus TB square plus AS square. And reason you will write as from equation 2 and 3. And this equation you will write as equation 9. Now from equation 6 and equation 9 we will get. Now observe the equation 6. What was the equation 6? TS square plus TQ square is equal to TA square plus AS square plus TB square plus BQ square. And equation 9 was this. So you have to compare this. We will get TA square plus TQ square is equal to TP square plus TR square. Hence we have, let's move on to the last part of the session, that is assignment. Here one question is given to you. It is similar to the first question we have solved today. So it is very simple one. In triangle ABC, point M is the midpoint of side BC. If AB square plus AC square is equal to 290 centimeter square, AM is given as 8 centimeter and you have to find that BC side BC. So you have to apply your Apollonius theorem and find length of BC. I hope you all have understood each and every concept we have discussed today. So thank you for watching this video and meet you in the next video.